6:04. Make a motion to bring the meeting to order.
So move.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. On today's agenda, start.
Make a motion to accept the minutes of last meeting.
Do I hear a second?
I'll second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
All righty. Town meeting warrant.
All right, so you guys each have a copy.
Yep.
In front of you. I just would like to ask, if you don't mind, if we can jump to the housing committee article so that Richard Tilburg, the chair of the housing committee.
Sure. What's on there?
One of them is the CPA article, so we can start there. CPA article start on
20,
page 11, article 20, page 11. So the article 24 we'll start with.
Article 24. So page 12.
We're starting here.
Oh.
Thanks. So, do you want to read article 24? I don't think you've seen it yet, right?
No. Article 24, to see if the town will vote pursuant to general law. Chapter 44B, to appropriate and transfer from the community preservation housing reserves the sum of $86,726.35 to transfer it to an affordable housing trust contingent on town meeting authorization of such a trust or take any other action relative thereto. Majority vote required. So that's how it reads.
Is that before setting up the trust?
It will be, it will appear before.
Okay.
No, I think I just swapped that actually.
Okay.
I moved the other one ahead.
Oh, good. Okay. So the other one would, okay. Shall I say something or?
Sure.
First of all, let me apologize profusely. You may have heard the little drama about 3 minutes ago. I had thought the attorney had drafted the articles and had sent them to Mark. I've been out scout for the last 2 days, so apologize for not having them here. I was on the phone, he's not in. We will get them to you. I guess they'll come in tomorrow. The first article we discussed a week ago would have been to set up the trust. We got some comments from members of the CPC subsequent to our conversation. They went to the attorney. The attorney has made all the comments, agreed with the comments. So we have a final document now that agrees with everything that I believe the CPC has asked for. If the trust is set up, if you all are in vote in favor of or endorsing the trust, then the article that you just read would then fund the trust with CPC money. There was a very quick discussion, or let me be brief as I can. Traditionally, a trust does work on property that it owns. The issue in Whately, of course, is that there are other housing, like the Spikes House, that the trust does not own, and there may be a need or requirement to use CPC funds pursuant to CPC law on a property the trust does not own. So the attorney put into the trust language that it can spend money on housing owned either by it or by others. So that is a little uniqueness in our trust as opposed to the rest of the Commonwealth, that it's, well, at least it, that we, the housing trust, can spend money on property it owns, and it can also spend money for affordable purposes on property it doesn't own. So that is kind of a little. The other quick thing is that when we told our attorney we're a small town, we want control by the Board of Selectmen, she came back and she said, anything over $100,000, you have to have the Board of Selectmen approve. So that was her definition of control. We moved it down to $5,000 and $10,000, which we think gives it control. I'd love to answer any questions, and I don't want to take up any more of your time.
What is the trust goals, and how do you come up with a number?
The number is, what happens is we have, the CPC gets a certain amount of money every year, 10% of that money has to go for affordable housing by law. It's a very small amount of money in Whately as opposed to other towns. That's just the full amount of money that has been adding up in the CPC housing fund. Right, and so that would be a one-time bump this year. Then from every other year, the CPC would be asked by the trust to put money into the trust that it had received for housing that year. So that's probably like $12,000 to $15,000 per year.
So moving forward, it'd be $12,000 to $15,000 in the budget, in the town budget that...
Yeah, well, the CPC gets whatever it gets. It must get $150,000 because 10% of that is $15,000. CPC gets about $15,000 in housing money. That's just been banking in the CPC. Now it would be banking in the housing trust, but the trust can spend it more easily for reasons we talked about last time.
Okay. And will you or someone from the committee be explaining to the voters of this town the rationale as to why we need to do this and the benefit that it has to the taxpayer?
Yes.
In this town.
In town meeting, absolutely. Okay. Unless you'd like.
Well, there's also a fact sheet that we put out. It's on our website.
Okay.
It's you have Whately.org website under the housing committee on there. A full page explains why, the benefits, the purpose of it, and all that. So I guess we could make that available as a handout.
Right.
For the
we
town
just
meeting.
Want to be ready so, at town meeting.
Yeah, yeah. For a short,
yeah.
Long range.
Well, we are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll take that.
You know, I'm guessing if you want the money moved, you have a plan.
Yes.
So shouldn't the placeholder for the trust be before this? I guess I missed.
It's been moved up.
It's been moved up. Yep. Okay.
It's in front of the. It's in front of this article now.
So if that doesn't pass, then this will be passed over. Okay.
And if you want to amend this article we're discussing now, you might want to take out the words "if the trust is approved," because if the trust is approved, it will be approved, and if it's not approved, we'll simply say
contingent on town meeting authorization of such a trust. That language.
Well, in there somewhere you said if the trust is approved. I don't know where it said.
Right here, contingent on town meeting authorization.
Yeah, if you want to keep it in, you can, but it's kind of redundant because that article would never come up.
Right.
If there were no trust. Okay. Small detail.
The money happens to be there.
Yeah, that's all I put for the.
And it's positive for the town.
Well, it's not costing. Well, I was going to say it's not costing anything, but
that's what Ron needs to explain.
Right.
It's
all
not costing the town already. The money's already there. It's just
it is
money's
costing.
There.
Mm-hmm.
We just discussed the fact that this trust allows the housing trust to be a little bit more nimble.
Sure,
for the property. And then I can get into that.
That makes sense. I think people will fall in line with that.
Yeah,
for sure.
Well, we can bring up the experience we have where we had a good piece of property that we
were. Right. Yeah. Are we all set on this?
So, in theory, if you guys want to vote on the articles all together rather than each individual article?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I think we should deal with the articles, and if there's an issue, I mean, discuss them if there's an issue. If not, go on.
Okay, that would be great.
And then at the end, yay, nay, or go away.
Okay. So I guess in theory, if you're okay with this article, then you're okay with the article. There's a placeholder in there for the article that would establish the trust. So
right.
Oh, no, we're not open to that.
We don't like the trust at all.
you'll notice that every article on the warrant does say recommended, and I will change that if need be. So it's just
right.
There as a placeholder for the
right.
Draft.
Okay, so what we need to do here is to thank you, Richard.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Starting with Article 1, I guess we'll start with Dan. We'll just keep going round and round until we're done.
The article 1 is here at the top. We'll vote to accept the annual report to the officers of the town in 2 years. Any other requests or boards or committees to take any other action relative thereto? Majority vote.
To see if the town will vote to authorize the town treasurer with the approval of the select board to borrow money from time to time in anticipation of the revenue of the fiscal year beginning July 1st, 2016, in accordance with the provisions of general law, chapter 44, section 4, and to renew any note or notes as may be given for a period of less than 1 year, in accordance with the provisions of general law, chapter 44, section 17, or take any other action related thereto.
Any comment?
Yeah, does that happen often?
It's a placeholder.
But this is a standard.
Right, but I just wanted to know if that happened. Article 3, to see if the town will vote to authorize the town treasurer with the approval of the select board to enter into compensating balance agreements with banking institutions having their principal offices in the Commonwealth during fiscal year 2017, as been permitted by the General Laws, Chapter 44, Section 53F, will take any other action relative thereto. Any questions?
Article 4, to see if the town will vote to apply for, accept, and expend any federal, state, or private grant monies on behalf of the town, and authorize the town treasurer with the approval of the select board to borrow in anticipation of reimbursement or take any other action relative thereto. Is that like what happened with Mill River?
Yes, the select board signed the contract to accept those funds.
Article 5, to see if the town will vote to authorize revolving funds for certain town departments under general laws, chapter 44, section 53E1/2, for the fiscal year beginning July 1, 2016, or take any other action relative thereto.
If you flip to, I just have one comment on this.
What's that saying?
That's to allow the revolving funds that are on page 2. So on page 2, the first one, dog licensing and control revolving fund, that limit has traditionally been $1,000, and I was asked to increase that to $2,000 because of training. It still would put a limit of $2,000 on that, but that's the only change in this chart. Otherwise, it's been the same for years. I think the last update to this is probably the rec revolving went up to $20,000 at one time.
So this is just allowing the revolving funds to accumulate up to a certain amount, or for spending up?
Both.
Okay.
And then any excess funds over these amounts roll over to the general fund at the end of the year for free cash, because they can't, you're not authorizing any more than the expenditure in that spending limit column.
So they can't use those next year, in the next fiscal year?
No.
They have to. Okay.
No.
Is this a complete list of all revolving funds?
Yes.
How long have we had a cordwood sales revolving fund? It didn't really long time.
I think it's been there for a while.
Which one?
The balance of all these accounts after our discussion last year, some of these accounts had crazy balances on them, and we rolled all those over. That's part of the reason why we had such a influx of free cash this year, because there were accounts here that only had a spending limit of $1,000 but had $9,000 in the account. It didn't make any sense. We would never be able to spend that money because you're only authorizing up to $1,000.
On the recreation, so that's $20,000 they can just spend during the year, or up to $20,000, and so that's like user fees and things like that. Is that also field use and all that as well? Or is that
I believe most of the fees in this revolving fund come from the programs. So they, you know, if your kid plays soccer, you pay $50 registration fee, and then they use that money to fund uniforms and things like that. So it's kind of, it's coming in and going out.
But as far as like the field usage fee of $40 or $50 or whatever, does that get rolled into this? What an outside
group.
That's
a good question. I don't know. Do you know? I haven't seen their turnover, so I don't know if it's being turned over to the general fund or whether it's being turned over to revolving. I can ask and find out.
Well, I think it's a good question.
I don't think there's a lot of the answers coming in, to be totally honest with you. So
yeah. So this is obviously over and above the budgeted.
Correct. This is separate from the operations budgets.
So you're saying all revolving funds that are not spent within that current fiscal year that they were accrued in will get turned over to free cash at the end of that fiscal year?
Anything in the accounts over these limits, yes.
Do these individuals know how they've spent this money? Because many didn't know how they spent the money from the budget.
This is tracked in the same manner. I mean, you'll see, and I realize the $20,000 on the rec fund is a large number, but the rest of them are all fairly small numbers. And the rec, I believe, was increased because they had some projects that they wanted to do, and they kept hitting their limit. A few years ago, you know, they were doing lots of upgrades to signage and fencing and things like that, and the limits they had set there were just too low. So that could probably come back down now. It just hasn't. They're not hitting it anyway. But that's probably something we should run by rec if that's something you're wanting to do. This allows them to pay their refs, pay their coaches. You know, any expense related to the program.
Okay. Which is why it would be nice to see a spending
where it goes
pattern. You know, it would.
One thing it goes $200.
It'd be kind of nice. You know.
The way I see these revolving accounts are like a petty cash fund. They don't have petty cash, which is always
right.
Helpful.
Yeah.
But in any petty cash accounting I've seen in the past, there is a list of what was received and what was expended and how it was expended.
Oh, yeah, we can get those reports. I mean, it's not going to be separated out into this is what we spent on uniforms and this is what we spent on whatever. You know, it'll be pretty much the same report that I showed you last time, where it's just the expenses are in order of the date they were submitted, and that's about it. So,
yeah.
But they're all there.
We just want to make sure that Joe's not getting $100 for a baseball game, and you're only getting $25.
Well,
so it's
yeah.
When they were
Joe,
expended
Joe
be
worth
on
yeah. Well, it would be both, but it would be in order of.
Okay.
In order
on what?
When they have.
Oh yeah. It'll say like. Whatever the trophy company is, $300.
That's fine. That's fine.
Okay.
Okay. Article 6: See if the town will vote to fix the salaries and compensation of the elected officers of the town for fiscal year 2017 as follows. Will take any other action relative thereto. And these prices are
the only adjustment.
Same thing, except 2% full increase.
Yep, that's it.
As we go through this, as you know, Finance Committee would this year like to address the town prior to the vote.
Of the budget?
Of the budget.
Okay.
Okay. And during that presentation, the Finance Committee would like to illustrate to the town what it costs the average household based on property price, property evaluation.
Right, we did that last year.
We did that last year. And every dollar amount that's in here, if we can.
For every dollar amount?
Not, well, in other words, for every article that they have to vote on in which there's a dollar amount that they're voting in or not,
Well, the budget is all one article, though. Like Article 8 is your fiscal year 17 budget.
Yeah, are you just referring to some of those other special articles?
Just the ones that are increased.
Not to the actual budget.
No, the, tell me.
Just these other articles that we go through here, what it's going to cost them for that.
Right. So, in these articles that we have voted, that we have approved, and dollars over and above what was spent last year, those are the specific ones that I would like to address. And if there's something in here that, from a dollar perspective, the average household, the average taxpayer out there should know, should understand what they're voting on or what they're voting in. So,
as an example, I think what you're saying is Article 9, $145,000.
Yeah. Right, right.
For the dump truck, Article 10, $13,000 for paving the highway.
So, just to clarify, let's focus on Article 9 and 10 for a second. Are you saying that you want to be able to say what the tax impact of Article 9 and 10 would be?
Yep. It's just like we did last year.
Okay. There will be no tax impact on most of these articles because they're being funded through free cash.
That doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Because the free cash got there because of
taxpayer.
So all we want to do is take that raw number, and we want to move forward, and we want to associate that number with the average household in town. And what that average household, what that taxpayer, they know what they pay, and they know whether when Keith's truck comes up for $145,000, even though it comes from free cash and it's not going to hit them, it has, that money was there from time.
So is this something you guys are doing? Or is
I'm going to do it.
Okay.
So yeah, I don't understand how you're going to $145,000.
That's what I'm asking.
Yeah, just take the total of the free cash, what it comes to, and just break it down a little bit. The people, you want to be able to show the people.
I know we're trying to show, yeah. I just don't, people look at what the tax rate is, mm-hmm. and if we're going up 50 cents, you can say, okay, based on this is what you're costing us, but I don't know how we're going to get that number.
Oh, it's doable.
Okay.
It's either from last year or previous years. This one isn't going to hit this year, but it did hit prior years.
So do you know how you're going to figure it out?
This dump truck will hit this year.
No, it will.
Yeah,
it will hit.
This dump truck will hit this year. Is that what you're talking about?
The tax rate?
Yeah. The dump truck will hit the tax rate this year.
But that's not one that's going to come out of free cash?
That's the capital articles, that's the only one, actually.
I'm thinking of the free cash expenditures.
Okay. Well, irregardless, it doesn't...
It's just a representation, because if you didn't spend it, your tax rate wouldn't go down.
No,
you just have...
It's just a representation of what
so
it
I
is.
So they can see what they're getting for their money, not saying, what are you going
to... Right, no, I get it. Yeah. But they have to understand that if they don't vote it in, their tax rate is not going down.
Right.
No, I mean, that's a...
But by that amount.
Pardon me?
It won't go up by that amount if you don't vote it in.
No, it's already, except for the dump truck.
Well, that's what I thought.
Okay, well, the dump truck, that's a tax rate.
That's
the only one. Mm-hmm. But everything else will not touch their tax rate. It won't lower it if they don't vote it in.
The ones that are being paid out of free cash.
Right. Okay. But they just have to know that. And it's a representation of the overall
because
money.
They did raise their taxes either last year or previous years.
Somehow that money got into the general fund, got into free cash.
Through taxes.
Through taxation.
Right, but that's back when it was $8, so you got to use $8 figures. It's not, I'm kidding.
Did you do that for the fire truck? I mean, you had a $400,000 item. Did people ever know the impact of that?
Yeah. We did that last...
Was that last year?
The last meeting, yeah.
I don't remember, but okay.
Yeah, we did. We started this last year, and we said to the town that moving forward, any of these articles that had a dollar amount attached to them that they had to vote on town floor, they would understand the impact to their pocketbook based on the average home in town.
I don't remember fire truck. This building, I remember you had this on there.
Yep.
The 800 some thousand for this, yeah.
It's a good practice. Well, I agree with it. I'm just glad I'm not the guy figuring it out because it's not.
He's retired.
You know, it's well, not, I just.
Well,
I just
we did it last year, so. You know.
I'm just worried that some of the smaller articles are just going to confuse people because a $10,000 improvement to the police department is may not have an impact on.
Well, for instance, we did last year. We did the longevity increase, which was pennies.
No, it was nothing.
It was
had no tax impact.
Right, had no tax, but people saw that and went, "What the heck?" Right. I mean, I think they would have voted it anyway, but after seeing that, they went, "Oh, geez, that's nothing."
It didn't even shift the tax rate by a penny.
No.
So
it works both ways.
Right. Yeah, I'm just worried that it may come off to voters. They may look at it and say, "Well, you know, maybe I'd rather not have a new police cruiser because I don't want my taxes to go up." When in fact, that's actually not the case. I get what you're saying that it does.
That's their right, though.
Yeah. No, of course. I mean, it's an article.
But it'll be explained.
Just for information.
It'll be explained so that it doesn't become misconstrued that they are putting money in their pocket if they don't vote for something.
You really think you need to, I kind of go along with him, you really think you want to do it for every little small expenditure?
Well, I think we should.
Or that we just set a limit of anything over that amount, then we would bring up on the chart like this.
I mean, that's, I'm fine with that as well. But why don't we go through these and see which ones are going to pertain to that?
Okay.
So you don't want to listen to why the police department or the highway department needs a new truck.
Well, you might have to listen to that anyway. It's an article.
No, I know that, but I know what people talk about, and that's the kind of stuff they talk about. Or why do they need it paved down there? It's good enough for them. Do I think it's good enough? No, but I mean, there's people there though. That's good enough for them.
Sure.
Especially in a small town.
That's why we ended up buying this building.
Right.
Those buildings are good enough for 60, 70 years. We would have never bought this building had we continued to upgrade.
Yep, you're absolutely right.
You know, and then the highway department comes and the guy needs the money for the electrical and he's, you know, he's holding back. He's waiting for somebody to get, you know,
shot.
Hurt.
Yeah, so they can justify it.
It's time. It's only 110, right?
Didn't happen very often.
It's not very often. You can't, kind of got him going in the morning, to say the truth.
When you see those guys hanging around, say, oh, those guys work the way they feel it.
Okay, where are we?
Article 6, we were looking at the COLA increases.
Okay.
Article 7, to see if the town will vote to appropriate $140,742 or any other sum or sums of money from the Water Department Enterprise Fund to finance the operations of the Water Department for the fiscal year beginning July 1st, 2016, or take any other action relative thereto.
Beat
this horse, haven't we?
Yeah.
And this is, again, won't impact the tax rate. This is water.
Right.
But it could impact the water rate.
Oh. It will impact.
Now, there is another discussion.
Absolutely.
Well, any water improvements ultimately are going to be borne by the taxpayer. Just like in Flint, Michigan, it is going to be borne by the taxpayer. People, water users are going to pay.
Water users, yeah, but not necessarily the taxpayers of the town.
No, but that's an interesting point, though. I was thinking about that the other day. You know what we talked about sometime in October, having a sit down with the water department as to how do we recoup some of the funds that the town has loaned to them. Well, some of those funds that were loaned to them were funds that they put in. You know, I mean, that was town money. That town that came from everybody in town, including the people that are in the enterprise fund. So it's going to be a very interesting
It's on their minds. I know they've mentioned it to me a couple times, and they're thinking about it. So I think you guys agreed this fall, you guys need to take up that conversation again.
You know, one thing would be interesting on this enterprise fund, if we take a look at the budget, the town budget, and what the bottom line is, what the tax rate is and everything, I mean, can they go through this budget and say this is what the water rate's going to be? Why not?
I honestly don't know how they set the water rate. I'm not involved in that process.
I think it's pretty magical. It should be pretty generic. Here's how much it costs. Here's how many gallons flow through it. Simple division is cost per gallon.
That's the magic. The answer to that question, though, is how much does it cost? And I think that's the moving target.
Right.
There needs to be some foresight, some planning.
Right.
And we're starting to see these things that are starting to fail on the system.
And they don't have any foresight or planning.
Yeah, so it's easy to go back and take a look at history.
Right.
But that doesn't do anything for us going forward as to what the rate is going to be. And I think it would be a shame to think that the enterprise fund is going to fund all this along with the users if something goes wrong based on the possibility that somebody didn't have any foresight to say this is, you know.
Right, well, even the little Whately Water District with its 40 members, they put in, like, I know there's over 1,000 in their pump replacement fund that this goes in every year. I mean, just it's like you say, a little foresight. Mm-hmm. It can't be rocket science.
I agree, and I would think that based on this, you should be able to say, this is what we want to spend. We know what we've got roughly coming in. Why can't they say this is what the rate is going to be for the year?
Right, expense.
Right.
Gallons used.
You know.
The division gives you rate.
And so that they can put some money aside for
I'm all for that. I mean, that's good
business.
Yeah,
that goes into their retained earnings.
That has a foresight.
Maybe the finance committee should take over setting water rates.
Yeah.
They seem to struggle when they were here the other day.
Well, they're afraid to tell people it's got to be more money. That's what they're struggling with. If it's more money, it's got to be more money.
It's still cheap.
I don't think
water is cheap.
I
know somebody that waters their garden all year and laughs because they pay $100 a year for their water.
Hey, cut it out.
But we won't mention any names.
You want to have foresight. You have to and say, okay, how much potentially just project
this year too.
You have to get out there and do the dirty work, and they're not going to do it. They're not going to do it.
Yeah, because what you're asking is to prorate everything. In other words, they just put in the meters. Right? That costs X number of dollars. Now, normally, you would prorate that over a 5-year period for recouping those monies.
Right.
So now you've got to figure that into your. It's not as easy as you say it.
That's how it works. That's how it works.
You also have to set up for the extra monies for pump, like you said, on the other well up there, stuff like that.
There's all of those costs that come in that have to be, you know.
But they're not just costs that you could say it costs this much to pump this much water. Because you've got to look forward.
Right. No, I agree.
As many years, and you can't predict sometimes when the failure is going to be on an item, like a pump or rewiring.
No, but you could add in a 5 or 10%.
No, and they don't have to have the cash sitting there. I mean, these big items, the town still will let them borrow that and pay it back, I'm sure, over a reasonable period of time. But
interest free.
Yeah, you know, I mean, I guess that's my point is I would think is here's our budget. Why can't they say this is what our tax rate's going to be? I mean, our water rate is going to be. They can come up with all these expenses. I don't know why you can't set it.
Because they have to do it anyway.
Right.
At some point in time, you have to set a rate.
Right.
When does that happen?
They've only made that one rate change since its existence.
They have
to go through a process with an EPU to increase their rates. So again, it's
never driven into that.
Yeah, there's public hearings. It's quite a process.
They're too high.
Yeah. But then why is there's three articles here for $30,000? They're asking for more money in addition to this one. Why is them separate and not included in here.
They don't have any foresight, that's
why. No. Those, I think what you're referring to...
Well, the truck was one that's already, was $5,000 over.
Those are capital items, and those are paid for by retained earnings. That's why they're not in the operations budget.
Retained earnings.
Yeah, you'll
okay.
see it says from retained earnings.
Yeah, okay.
In the article.
All right. Where are we? Article 8?
Yes.
Is it me?
Yeah,
it is. Article 8, to act on the report of the Finance Committee on the fiscal year 2017 budget and to raise, appropriate, or transfer from available funds money for the operation of towns, departments, and the payments of debt service and all of the necessary and proper expenses for the year, or take any other action relative thereto. Note, what department enterprise fund costs are appropriated in Article 7. Finance Committee recommends that the amount shown in the column captioned FY17 Finance Committee recommendations be removed. We raise our appropriate or transferred from available funds for FY17 department operating purposes, debt service, and other town expenses. And there they are, ladies and gentlemen.
So everything from here to the top of page 9 is what you voted on at your last meeting.
Right. Following 11 articles are recommendations of the Capital Planning Committee.
You know.
Go.
Article 9, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate or borrow the sum of $145,000 for the purpose of a dump truck for the Highway Department as part of the 2017 Capital Improvement Plan and authorize the Treasurer with the approval of the Select Board to issue any bonds or notes that may be necessary for that purpose as authorized by General Laws, Chapter 44, Section 7, Number 9, or any other general or special law for a period not to exceed 3 years, or take any other action relative hereto. Two-thirds vote required.
Questions, comments, issues? Article 10.
To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate or transfer from available funds a sum of $13,000 for paving the Highway Department lot to the salt shed, or take any other action relative thereto.
Questions? Comments? Good. Article 11.
Article 11, see if the town will vote to raise appropriate transfer from available funds the sum of $18,000 to purchase an emissions exhaust system for the Fire Department, or take any other action relative thereto.
That's a nice number now.
Yeah, that's if it stays and it doesn't cost, you know, more per year.
Yeah,
that's true. It's not be an operating
increase. Yeah.
Okay.
Article 12,
to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate or transfer from available funds the sum of $10,000 to complete repairs to the police department building by installing fencing, lighting, and completing the paving in the parking lot and walkway areas surrounding the police department, or take any other action relative thereto.
Okay. How long has the police department been there?
He mentioned the other day he'd been with us for, I think, 16 years.
How long has it been there?
More than that? Yeah. 92?
Been there since Sal gave up the use of it as the youth building. So that goes back quite a few years.
I'm going to guess 10 or 12. Maybe.
No way, it's more than 10. They were still in.
I don't think so either.
It was less than. I've been on this committee for less than 10 years, and they were still being downstairs, or they still had the office downstairs. Or
they were at the new location when I started, and that was 6 years ago.
I'm going to say that's just probably just about right, maybe 6 or 7 years.
It was after the first study you did on the town hall, town buildings, whatever that was, shortly after that, because that came from that study.
How do you know?
Three, 4 years ago.
No, man, I thought that was like in the 90s, early 90s, 91, 92, when that study was done. And one of the buildings they looked at was that building and putting the police there. And that's why I think the police ended up there.
Well, anyway, anyway.
It was all before my time.
Yeah.
Or is there something?
Why did we want to know that?
I just wanted to know what, you know, realistically, they'd never done anything there, you know, kind of how much, you know, what you're doing there.
Right. And someone's set to explain that paving in that area, plus there's the salt shed.
Two articles in the judge.
I'll have the department heads make the motion. Well, no, actually, Jim
should have a visual.
Jim can't make the motion, so he'll be there to at least explain.
Keith will be there.
So
he did to us. He can present.
I was just trying to get a handle. You know, if it's been there 10 years, it's $1,000 a year. They haven't really done anything.
No, the chief needs to be there. He has a cruiser on there. He has another article on here. He needs an operating budget.
He needs a carport.
Next thing would be shuffleboard. Okay. Who's got Article 13? Dan, you're up.
Okay, see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the transfer from available funds to sum of $35,000 to replace a model year 2009 cruiser for the police department to take any other action relative.
Alrighty.
That's a Prius, too, right?
It's a Prius. Make sure they know that.
Article 14, see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate or transfer from available funds the sum of $15,000 for repairs to the roof, gutters, and entrance improvements at the S. White Dickinson Library or take any other action relative thereto.
And they'll be there. They will be there. Mm-hmm. So that's good. Okay, Article 15, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate or transfer from available funds the sum of $3,000 to purchase a storage shed for the Blue School Field located 219 Christian Lane to take any other action relative thereto. 16.
Article 16, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate or transfer from available funds a sum of $6,000 to purchase and install padding at the Whately Elementary School Gymnasium and take any action thereto. I'm still not sure why the school doesn't do that. It's not in their money.
They're splitting it with the school. So the school's
why should they split it?
I don't know. I'm just telling you, it's a $12,000 project that is being divided between the town and the school.
Is it for the elementary school?
Yeah.
They're out of money.
That's not my fault.
I'm just telling you why they're asking for it. There's other articles that are eventually going to come to our budget.
I think what they had spoken to just before saying that needed for recreational programs and things like that.
Still not sure why the school's not going.
Well, it's going to be about money.
Well, I just want to hear something sad.
Yeah.
I'm not sure that gymnasium gets a whole lot of use out of the rec department.
Yeah.
Or they're at least a good user of it, and, basketball season and whatnot. And this is a way to spread it out over the rec committee and the school so that not one organization has to take the full hit. It's pretty important.
Yep. Okay, Article 17.
Article 17, to see if the town will vote to transfer from water department retained earnings, free cash, the sum of $10,000 to complete the purchase of a pump house generator for the water department or take any other action relative thereto. This is the enterprise retained earnings or free cash.
Correct.
So it doesn't affect our.
It's not coming
in.
It doesn't affect somebody who doesn't have water, so I can vote no against this in a vote.
But it also doesn't affect the tax rate.
Right. It doesn't affect the tax rate, which is another interesting point. You have the general taxpayer population voting on this, but yet the general taxpayer population. Really,
but the enterprise fund is set up so that everything that they spend has to be voted by the town meeting.
Yes.
So that keeps them, honest.
Yeah.
You'll notice that these next few articles also have the recommendation of the water commissioners added to them.
Okay. Article 18.
Are they going to say no?
Well, if we explain that it's not going to affect their tax rate, maybe.
See if the town will vote to transfer from the water department retaining earnings free cash fund the sum of $5,000 to build capital for the replacement of the water department truck at FY19. Taking other actions
Sounds a little funny.
So this is part of the planning process for the input system to set money aside.
Yes. So we could add pump to that, and we could add filtration filters to that, to go along with what you were saying, Dan.
Yeah. Isn't this to pay for the truck?
It's a capital item.
Right. No, they're building capital to pay. So every year, last year was the same exact article. They just put $5,000 of senior earnings in a separate account, and then when they have to replace it,
it's there.
It's there.
Okay, Article 19.
To see if the town will vote to transfer from Water Department retained earnings, free cash, a sum of $15,000 for cleaning and waterproofing for the Water Department tank, or take any other action relative thereto.
Okay. Following six articles are recommendations of the Community Preservation Committee.
They will be there to make these motions.
They will be there.
Yes.
To see if the town will hear and act pursuant to General Laws, Chapter 44B, on the report of the Community Preservation Committee for the fiscal year 2017 Community Preservation Budget, and vote to appropriate a reserve from the Community Preservation Fund a sum of money in the amounts recommended by the Community Preservation Committee for community administrative expenses, community preservation projects, and other necessary and proper expenses in the fiscal year beginning July 1, 2016. Including debt service for any approved community preservation project, with each item be considered a separate appropriation. That's a mouthful. And this is exactly the kind of thing when people go to town meeting, they go, what the heck is it? How much money? Right. What's that for? You know, I mean, someone has to put this into English for people there. Even though people will just.
It's got to be legal, too, though.
Well, yeah. Yeah, don't mind me. It's going to be like this.
So they understand it. It ain't legal.
But some, don't you think one of them has to stand up and say, in other words, we want to do X, Y, and Z. In order to do that, we need this article passed.
Well, I think as with any of these, as soon as somebody makes a motion and seconds it, that opens the floor for discussion.
But so is that a money article? It was just read?
Yes.
Yeah.
So this is to be expended out of 2017 revenues from, which is part of our tax rate.
Right.
So yeah, that's, those would, although
well, no.
It's a percentage of our.
Right, I mean,
it's the appropriate, from fiscal year 2017 estimated revenues for committee administrative expenses. Is this the block party you've been talking about, John? $7,600. Okay. And then from reserves, $15,600 from historic reserve, historic resource reserve, $15,600 from community housing, and $15,600 from open space, and $95,600 from budgeted reserve.
Was that free cash?
No, these are all saying that these items, these are all parts of the community preservation.
So
all the money's been collected, and this is just saying we are going to take this percentage and put it into this group,
right.
This percentage into that group. If this $15,600 doesn't go into, if we say no, then the community housing reserve isn't going to be funded on years going forward.
How much is in the community preservation fund?
Let me check. You guys did get this report also the other day, Monday.
Oh, that came. Okay.
Yeah. So you're going to start receiving these when we receive them, as any department does. So there will be a CPA sheet in there that will give you all the balances on all these accounts.
That'll be great before budgeting season.
Especially. Yeah, you're going to get it every. You'll get it every month now. So.
So this is really just a housekeeping article,
pretty much.
If you guys want to keep going, I'll try to find the balance.
Okay. Number 21, Article 21.
Yep. To see if the town will vote pursuant to General Laws, Chapter 44B, to appropriate and transfer from the Community Preservation Fund Open Space Reserves and the Community Preservation Fund Budgeted Reserve, the sum of $16,000 is the town's match for a permanent agricultural preservation restriction on 17.6 acres of farmland on the west side of Long Plain Road, north of the Whately Elementary School, Assessor's Map 26, Lot 24, currently owned by Ed and John Simorowski and Beverly and Don Wilson, upon such terms and conditions as the Select Board in consultation with the Agricultural Commission shall deem appropriate.
So where's that?
The west side of Long Plain Road.
I think it's just past the what used to be Pelock's house.
Let me think. No, back up this way. Just before Bill Smith's.
Yeah.
Right?
Okay.
Between Bill Smith's and Don Bates.
Oh, they were just
surveying.
Surveying it.
Yeah.
I think that's the spot.
Okay.
Who
were Beverly and Don Wilson?
Wilson.
Thank you.
Okay. Beverly's their sister.
Oh.
The what?
Beverly is John and Ed's sister.
All right, good. Article 22.
To see if the town will vote pursuant to General Laws, Chapter 44B, to appropriate and transfer from the Community Preservation Fund Historic Resource Reserve and the Community Preservation Fund Budgeted Reserves the sum of $30,000 for the preservation and repairs of compromised and deteriorating stones identified in the 2013 master plan provided by Gravestone Services of New England, work to be done under the direction of the cemetery commissioners or take any other action relative thereto.
Good. Good.
Ian? Okay, Article 23. See if the town will vote in pursuant of General Laws, Chapter 44B, to appropriate transfer from the Community Preservation Fund Budgeted Reserves the sum of $84,000 for the fund, the reserve preservation of bid-ready documents to rehabilitate the town hall for the Historical Society and Museum collections and to serve as a community center for social, recreation, cultural use, or take any other action relative to that.
You got a typo on that one, Mark. Okay. Which Article 23.
I have a question, maybe a semantics on that, but to me, the way it reads, it's for rehabilitate town hall for the Historic Society Museum. We're not rehabilitating it for Historic Society. It's rehabilitating to be used by the Historic Society and others. Historic Society is not own the building. Otherwise, we're not. Otherwise, we're spending money on a nonprofit private enterprise.
Right.
Just to.
In fact, I would put them, well, you could list them last.
We haven't had any comment back from the chair of this committee yet, either on these articles.
And that wording was taken directly from the application that was approved by the CPC.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Any other comments, questions? Article 24.
See if the town will vote pursuant to General Law, Chapter 44B, to appropriate transfer from the Community Preservation Housing Reserves the sum of $86,726.35 to transfer into an affordable housing trust contingent on the town meeting authorization of such a trust or to take any other action relative thereto.
You guys voted on this one, right?
To see if the town will vote pursuant to General Laws Chapter 44B to close the following CPA accounts and return the funds to the following reserves. You can see them now. I'm not going to read them all through. Any issues with any of those, any of the movements? Is there anything that we don't that doesn't seem kosher yet?
That's basically unspent money that's going back to the buckets. It's all of this.
Okay.
All right. What does it go back to?
It goes back to those designated buckets that are all the way on the right hand side.
Archive vital records are good, so they're all going. Yeah.
So, Dan, we could take a look. We've already paid for the repair for the Frontier tennis courts.
Yes, we have.
There's only a balance of $155 left there.
built in Whately.
Okay.
Who's it up to date?
26.
It's 26. Goes to, I've lost count. Who's up?
26 should be moved up in front of.
26, housing trust placeholder.
Yeah, I just read the last one. It is you.
So that's the one you're going
to
move.
Article 27, to see if the town will vote to raise an appropriate or transfer from available funds a sum of $115,000 for hospice renovations at the Whately Town Office Building, or take any action relative thereto. That's here?
Okay, yes. And this is somewhat coming out of left field, so I assume that it'd be a lengthy conversation.
Especially since it's so small, where a CPA gets like half a page.
Yeah.
CPA has all the money.
Yeah.
In drafting this warrant article, it occurred to me that we have an opportunity to secure some funding for the renovations of that south window side of the building
space. Yeah.
We have right now an estimate for the modular offices, which includes the 10-foot wall to divide the spaces from the larger space. It includes all the office partition walls, doors, windows. The panels come pre-wired, and that came in about just under $50,000. I'm in the process now of getting some estimates from the HVAC company, Brodsky, to come and move a couple air ducts in that area. The only other expense that we would have to absorb in that renovation would be an emergency exit, carpeting for the offices, not for the hallway, just the individual offices.
Carpeting.
Just for sound.
Sound. They're only going to have 8-foot walls, so.
We're not doing the full walls to keep the cost down.
And the 8-foot walls also allow us to renovate without having to move sprinkler heads and adjust HVAC. And then some furnishings. I don't expect a lot, to be totally honest with you, in the way of furnishings, mostly file cabinets, because we will basically just move the desks that we have and we're using now into the space.
Scott, be happy.
Scott. The estimates that we had for this renovation through the architect were in excess of $200,000,
right.
So we really reeled this back to make it as affordable as possible.
We've totally eliminated the architect. Got the approval from the building inspector. We don't have to do the 34E, this big $20,000 architectural report on airflow and this type of thing. So we're good to go. This company with the panels, although we'll have to RFP, will come in with fully stamped plans that the building inspector said he'll accept. So we kind of cut $100,000 out of the middle.
What this would mean though is funding it from free cash. So that's, I guess, the question. Well, first of all, the question is whether you support the idea of continuing down the path of renovating that side of the building. And then the next question.
That's looking forward. That's what you do. That's what you do. What's the time frame?
Fairly tight. Once things were approved, I think it was a 60-day on the panels. They install the panels, but the company comes in, puts them in. We don't touch it. So I'm going to say 6 months, just to make it real.
What's that leave us in free cash?
Just over 100, about 125, I think, which is a little bit more than where you were last year after all capital items were paid for at town meeting. So you're not any worse off than last year, but it is a question of whether that's how you want to spend your money. So the balance of free cash after our special town meeting was 531 and 192. You have 100,500 in free cash articles outside of the enterprise fund. You're offsetting taxation by 200,000. So if you were to spend $115 to renovate without borrowing from free cash, that would leave you with about $116,000 in free cash.
What if we made this $100,000? We had
to come up with a number. Originally, we were shooting in the 125 range.
I know 15 is not a lot, but when you start talking about the free cash number, I like to be a little bit more flush than we were last year. I think we're heading in that direction. I think we had took a healthy amount to fund the budget. And my free cash guy that usually sits over there, that I think he has a pretty good handle on it. But it's $100,000. You're talking $50,000 for the walls. Is that going to get you there? I think that, again, $15,000 isn't a lot, but I'd rather have it going towards free cash than going towards really an unknown right now. I don't know what anybody else thinks.
Well, you can always come back and get it down the road. You don't have to say, let's do it now.
No, we could have we love special town meetings here in Whately, so we can have a town meeting.
There'll always be one coming up, because I'm sure the water isn't done.
The water filtration?
No, whatever they need.
I know the kind of connection.
That's a looking forward thing. I think they're stuck in the mud and I can't.
What should sway us here, what should sort of be factored in is a town of our size, what is considered a safe or effective free cash amount?
I don't think that basically your free cash, if you were to, let's say you fully funded this project, you fully offset taxation with the $200,000, and you funded all of your capital items, that would leave you, like I said, with $116,000 of free cash. That free cash essentially has to get you until June 30th, when the books close, and then we can't touch free cash again until November when it's recertified. And then you're starting with another, they'll take that free cash amount and add it to whatever. So basically,
that's why I asked about the time frame, if you can split it.
Can I just read you something from the Finance Association of Town Finance Committee? This is in the glossary under free cash. Typically, a community will attempt to maintain a free cash balance of between 3% and 5% of its total budget as a hedge against unforeseen expenditures to ensure there will be an adequate reserve to prevent sharp fluctuations in the tax rate and to prevent expensive short-term borrowing. So what's 5% of our $4 million budget? This is a forecast for 2017. So obviously, if we're left with 100,000,
that's the high number.
That's only going to work.
That's the four.
Well, you're left with $100,000 until June 30th, and then when the books close, you're locked out of free cash anyway until it's certified again in the fall. You can't touch it.
So this 100,000 is only going to hold us.
This $116,000 would be what you would have until June 30th. It only has
2017
to carry
2017 or
2016. No,
okay.
So it would be from basically May and June.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We should be able to hang in there with $116,000, and then.
What? Until November though.
Yeah.
Until the end of the next.
Well,
year.
No. It's really just till June 30th. You're locked out of touching free cash as of July 1st anyway.
Okay, but they recertify in November, and that's when you can.
That's when you can spend it again. So typically, you probably have a special town meeting shortly after that to fund anything that you've been wanting to fund since July 1st on. Mm-hmm.
So the only period of time that we can use that $116,000 is through June 30th.
Correct.
So we can't spend anything after that until November.
That's right.
Whether we had it or not.
Yeah, but you still have it in November. You got November,
correct.
December, January, February,
right.
March.
No, November you get your new.
Right.
Well, you get your new. What I'm just saying is
your new monies.
Yeah, but it's not like it's free money.
I
mean, you know, that's how we got to this free cash point to begin with, when we're going to fund the budget with $200,000. I mean, if that's the case, I'd roll the dice and say we're not going to spend anything. We're going to be disciplined, and we're just going to wait for the new influx of
Why I asked the time frame. If you waited till after, I don't know.
I mean, we could wait until after free cash is certified in the fall. It just pushes it off that much.
And I guess I'll go back to
how important it is to do it.
So, well, we have $115,000. What do we have for hard costs right now? $50,000?
So far, yes.
It'll be closer to 80. Ductwork, wiring. We got to cut a door in. I think we got to cut in that.
Right, and we
can the highway department do that?
Well, they could do the initial demo. The door being cut into that block wall.
But the 116,000 is after the 115,000 is right. Taken out.
Right.
So we've got 230,000.
Right. If you decide not to fund this at the end of town meeting, even if everything passes, you would still have $230,000 in free cash.
I mean, I don't know. I don't know what the. Is it important now?
Well, I can tell you it's important for a few reasons. We have zero security in our treasure collector office right now, other than being able to lock this door in the hallway. We really need, so if we don't fund this, then we have to, at the very least, fund a wall to close that area off.
So she doesn't have a closed office?
Right now, it's not closed off.
It's just, we should take most of you have seen it, but we've just got a big plastic partition up where we want to put the wall.
The other thing is, we put that wall, that plastic partition wall up to really cut down on our heating expenses over the winter. The building inspector wants that now, ASAP. Mm-hmm. So what I'm saying is if we open that up, we're just gonna be wasting heat. That whole area is one, I mean, it's actually two zones, but there's no separation. So the hot air from the heated zone is just being lost in the giant cold zone. So we have some issues in that aspect. I mean, we could just say, you know, I'm not trying to say you have to fund this. One option would be to seriously scale it back and put up some walls. But at the very least, we have to do that before we go into the next one.
So what else for town hall would you need? I mean, is that
next step?
Yeah.
This building is phase one.
Yep.
That's phase two. Phase three is going to be the vault, which is a room about half this size, conditioned, fireproofed, etc. State law.
Just over $100,000.
Yeah, but we think we can do it ourselves significantly less.
But that's not in.
That's phase three. We're trying to just keep doing it out of free cash. I understand it's not free, but trying not to hit the tax rate. And then phase four is turning the meeting room into a true meeting room. The other beauty of putting the wall up is if this SCEMS scenario happens, there's going to be a full construction zone out there, and we've got employees. We got the plastic wall up, but
yeah, it's going to be hot.
Well, it's going to be noisy. You know, if we do work out there, right? People in here wide open up.
Yeah, exactly. I get the fact it's got to be done.
Free cash between now and July 1st. Let's just go for it.
I probably learned more about free cash in the last 15 minutes than
15 grand is going to make.
So that's not going to make.
And we're not going to spend more than it takes.
Yeah, I just, you know, again, I like having that, because next year, if we continue taking too much free cash next year, that $100,000 that you're looking for the vault, you know, if we need to take another $200,000, $250,000
right,
to help balance the budget to keep the tax rate down, I just want to make sure that we continue
We won't push the vault unless we think we're financially able.
But I do appreciate the fact of continuing to move forward and get this building where it needs to be.
Yeah, and I think the treasurer should have it closed off.
Yeah, it really needs some security. The other benefit to renovating that section is that the long-term plan is to use this office on the other side of the wall for only the offices that really don't have any staff, so we can bring that zone way down, you know, into the 50s. It's not going to be right.
Yeah.
Where we have to heat that zone anyway, so the plan is to move the staff that is using that space now over into the zone we're already heating.
Oh, yeah.
And bring that way down. So it's all part of the master plan, I guess.
These new controllers that you've got put in, he can literally almost control every room. It's incredible what can happen.
Yeah.
We had no control before.
Well, I would think we should go.
I think it needs to be a little more.
What you think the wording?
I think it needs to be a little more.
We'll have more numbers.
Yeah, because people are going to say 115,000 for what?
Well, we have the biggest number, which is going to be the modular offices, and I'm working now on getting some of the smaller numbers, and if we find out by town meeting that we actually can do this for less, there's no reason why somebody can't make a motion to reduce it. We can't go above it, but we can reduce it.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I just think that if you take everything in total and start adding, stop looking at everything that we're buying and improving upon, and you know the tax rate's down a half buck, but it's a revalue year, and I don't know what's going to happen with that. I think next year, to be honest with you, I think it's going to be a very lean year. I think last year we did the fire truck. We're doing, this year we've got the dump truck. We've got the police car.
I don't think you're going to have much on capital next year at all.
Well, that's good.
Oh, not.
No, I mean, you've basically funded it in a year when you had sufficient free cash, which was a good idea. You're not borrowing for it. But if you look at the 2018.
I would agree with what you said. It could be a lean year, but when you had the opportunity, we took it and moved forward quite a bit.
Oh, we did.
I mean, we really moved the football down the field, and it's, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, there's no getting it back. It's down there. And we got a.
All of a sudden you can look and you can say, well, you know what, you know, now what? You're like, oh, now what? Let's just breathe a little and see where we're at.
So
like the highway department.
That free cash number that includes Article 13. I know I haven't go back. 30. Article 30. I haven't read it yet, but.
Right.
Yes. Yes.
So that includes that?
Absolutely.
So there's enough money to fund that.
Right. So right after the last special town meeting, your balance was $531,000. If you subtract out your capital articles, which we just went through, that's $100,500.
Yeah.
If you subtract out $200,000 to offset taxation, which is this.
Yeah.
That's what gets you down to the 230.
Okay. Right. All right.
And then this 115 then drops it down to 116.
Okay. We hadn't read that yet, so I wanted to be sure that was.
Yeah, that is. Yeah.
Are we ready for Article
28?
Yep. Okay. Article 28. To see if the town will vote to authorize the select board to petition the general court for special legislation to allow Peter Hanum, a town of Whately, call firefighter, notwithstanding the provisions of any general or special law to the contrary, to serve in such position until the age of 70 or until the date of his retirement or non-reappointment, whichever occurs first, provided, however, that no deductions from the regular compensation of Peter Hanum shall be made under Chapter 32 of the general laws, subsequent to his reaching the age of 65 in connection with his service to the town for retirement or pension purposes, provided, however, that the general court may make clerical and editorial changes of form only to the bill unless the select board approves amendments to the bill prior to enactment by the general court, and to authorize the select board to approve such amendments, which shall be within the scope of the general public objectives of the petition, or take any other action relative thereto. And I have no idea what I just read.
This has got more info in it than the article we're going to spend $150,000.
Yeah, but you get Pete Hanum.
Yeah, man, you're going to get it anyway.
And it might cost us more money.
Yeah.
That's the other thing. So why do you, because there was a mandatory retirement?
Massachusetts requires police and firefighters to retire at 65 unless you get this approval at town meeting.
So this is just an authorization, there's no money involved?
There's no money involved. All that language about pension and retirement is just standard operating procedures.
Yeah.
Okay.
How old is Peter? I guess he's 65.
65.
Subsequent to his reaching the age of 65.
Yeah, I think he's close. I think he's about to turn 65.
He's close.
You used to hang around with him,
yeah? He was my neighbor.
Counts. Okay, are we good?
Yeah.
Article
28? That was
28. 29. All right, Article 29, see if the town will vote to authorize the select board to act in the best interest of the town to negotiate in order to make changes to the South County Emergency Medical Service, SEMS, intermunicipal agreement, IMA, or take any other action relative thereto.
Sounds good.
Article 30, to see if the town will vote to authorize the Board of Assessors to transfer from free cash the sum of $200,000 to reduce the tax levy for FY17 or to take any other action relative thereto. Majority vote required.
Good. Anything
else? Oh, I'm good. Taking a vote. Is that it? The record on these articles.
I do have one question: is what we get for $84,000 for the preparation of bid-ready documents for the town hall?
Bid-ready documents for town hall.
You get $84,000.
You get plans.
And they're chipping in. They, the friends of the town hall, are adding $10,000 to that. So you're actually, it's $94,000.
And what? Yeah, I just like, what do you get?
Who's the architect?
The same as before. Jones Winslow.
Margo Jones.
Yeah.
Did that go out to bid? They just.
I don't.
She seems to get them all.
Yeah, there was. Well, the theory there was that because they'd done the $180,000 plans.
Right. Why did you just use those?
They would get quite a discount by using them once again.
Yeah.
Really?
There was some discount. I think it went from $120,000 to $94,000, I believe is the numbers.
We did get a legal opinion on whether we could use the prior town hall contract.
Prior ones. Mm-hmm. He's just got to redraw some of the stuff that is applicable to the new new code book coming out, which the original specifications, bid changes, were not up to code because the new code book just came out. So now they got to go through and change all that stuff. And but he basically said that $123,000 or $124,000 was the original, but he came down to $94,000.
Okay. So as we add this up, 240 from the first one, 15 years ago, 180 from this one. Now
we could have done the whole thing.
Now we're 80. Now we're moving over. Now we're heading towards $750,000 in basically pieces of paper. And so what's the? Is there somebody there who's keeping an eye on this thing, like? There's supposed to be like a clerk of the works, but there was supposed to be one the last time. State of Massachusetts mandates that on these types of projects, there'd be somebody hired and to just watch the books and make sure everything flows.
During construction.
Yeah, right. Even before construction though, right? Because wouldn't they have to have some impact on the plans as they were? I don't know.
I just have a hard time with the number of what you're going to get when they're already done once.
Yeah.
I mean, this, I can't believe it's going to vary very much what's already there.
Well, it's true. So
I think that the time it's going to take to do that, he's probably going to do it in one day. A draft machine.
What changes? Does anybody know what changes are going to be done?
There's a presentation to explain it.
Yeah, coming up next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday?
Supposed to be the last night.
Yeah, it got canceled.
Okay, net here?
Town Hall.
I believe it's 7 o'clock Wednesday. It's posted on our website also, and there's signs around town. But that will be your best shot at
it. I'll tell you, it's I think we need to go ahead and you know, do something with that building. I'm sure everybody else does as well. But yeah, you'd have to be foolish not to feel a little, I'll use the technical term, oogie, about saying, about giving anybody a green light to spend more money on that building for something you can't put your arms around. I think that last year, I think the quote was, we were done, the finance committee was done spending money on architects and consultants, yeah, and not having a return.
Results.
Not having a concrete return for it.
I don't know what they're going to get for $94,000. I don't care if the guy gives them a discount. I can't believe they're going to come in and come up with something new. It's not like the footprints change. It's not like anything's changed. It's all the same.
Well, if something has changed, then...
Well, the same architect is getting the job.
No, I think that some of the things that have changed from the original is... the openness of the downstairs. Originally, it was supposed to be a lot of offices in there, right? In the original drawing. So this is just going to eliminate some of those.
Yeah, it would eliminate that wing also. This would just be first and second floor with a lift to the second floor.
So how is that going to change from what they came up with originally?
I don't know. I haven't been involved in this process.
Well, they just have to draw it up. This is the law. You can't build something without getting an architect to do it. It's part of the building cost, period. And nothing else you can do about it. You can't get around it.
Are they going to fix that window?
Well, it's all fixed.
It is?
See, that shows how much you view this.
I just went by there a couple of weeks ago, and it wasn't fixed. It still had a
big door. I don't like it, but
but it was supposed to be fixed.
I mean, you got to move forward, but I don't like
$84,000. Plywood fell off is what happened.
I mean, the guy wants a new police car for $40,000, and there's going to be more talk about that than this.
Yeah, because he just isn't going to look good in Prius. It's just two of them together riding around.
With your prisoner in the back.
With the prisoner, it's not going to be pretty, but effective. Let's go one by one on this thing. Dan?
One by one on the articles?
Yep.
I thought we were going to review them all and discuss them.
No, well, just with regard to the 80, how much?
84,000.
84,000.
Article 23.
Do you feel in support of that?
Do I feel as though I support that?
Is this a vote or just a conversation?
It's a conversation.
Okay. I just wanted to know for the minutes.
No.
I really have a hard time supporting the majority of this stuff that's been going on about the town hall, because I don't feel as though it's been addressed right from the beginning. And I think at this stage of the game, we're in a correction process to try and lower the cost as low as they could to get the town to do it. And in order to do that, you have to go through the architect again.
We potentially are going to spend $84,000 on a project, and they can come up with whatever number you want on it, $1 million, right? And then we're gonna go try to get this thing funded, and potentially it's gonna get shot down again. And we're going to be $84,000 in the hole.
Absolutely, that's my thought. I wouldn't.
And my feelings aside, personal feelings aside, I think what I whether I think it's right or whether it's wrong direction that we go in with this thing, I don't think the town will support it. If that number comes back, I don't think they'll support it.
Did you get an answer to your question about there being a clerk of the works?
Apparently, I don't know. He said it has to start during construction.
I don't think you have a clerk of the works until construction.
Okay.
This is just
who's in control of all this, what's happened so far?
Nobody.
The committee?
Municipal building committee.
Building committee?
Yeah.
And now the historical commission has joined with building commission.
And collectively they applied for the CPA funding to fund our function.
I think we're all in agreement here that we can't again put the town in a position where it's an open-ended target. We don't know what that number is going to be downstream. If that number is $2.1 million,
I believe the number is 1.4.
And I think that's as important as anything, is this $84,000.
How do you know it's 1.4 when you didn't get this done yet?
Because that's what they told the architect to draw to.
Okay.
Yeah. See, that's, you know, and so, I mean, this is, you're not, you know, this isn't transparent, you know, this whole thing isn't transparent. This is a cart before the horse. I mean, I can come up with all these different things to say, but it's just wrong. If we know that we want to draw these plans to $1.4 million, then come right out there and say that this is going to be an $84,000 bid-ready documents for a $1.4 million building. And I'll tell you right now that that's not going to pass, and we want to just
throw $84,000.
Kiss $84,000 away again.
That's why we bought this building, to avoid those kinds of.
And what's the cell tower? What are we getting on the land for the cell tower?
We're gonna put that on hold until the town hall vote's over.
Yeah.
1.2 to 1.6 something million.
Okay, they were being asked to draw to 1.4. Mm. 1.2, 1.6, 1.4 falls right in there.
Is it that funny? That's amazing.
You know, the last time that we had a discussion on the town hall, I was told by a previous select person that it was my responsibility to be able to vote yes for this so the town could vote on it. But I really, as it stands after the conversation that we just had, I feel it's my responsibility to not recommend this and to say that we're not transparent, the numbers aren't there, and we spent enough money, and you know, as a finance committee member, I just think that it's wrong. I agree, and I'll tell you, I know what you're saying, but I don't like that.
I agree that this whole Article 23 is not worded properly. It shouldn't be worded like it is, because it sounds like it's being done just for two entities.
Right. It sounds like it's another exploration.
Well, it's saying it's being done for the Historical Society.
Well, that too.
Right? Yeah. And I agree with what you're saying. The total number, which they know, but what the architect is going to come up with, should be included in this article.
Yes.
As a reference point.
Absolutely. I think that has to. For the sake of transparency, that needs to be in here. That somehow that needs to be worded in, that the committee, with the approval of the select board, has a $1.4 million goal, and in order to get there,
the select board hasn't voted on that.
Well, I think that they have. I think in order for us to say, to feel comfortable supporting this, we have to know that they're watching the dollar, that this isn't open-ended, and that, you know, what the way it was last time. And we get a selectman on town floor trying to scare everybody that we're going to get sued if we don't vote
the
thing in.
Right.
You know, I'm not supporting that again. I mean, I gave them one pass on that. That's not going to happen a second time. I mean, I feel bad for them. That's the way it went, but...
So if we don't recommend it, will it still go to the floor as a vote recommended by selectmen and the preservation committee?
Well, the community preservation committee has voted on this article.
That's only because they have 84,000 in their pocket.
The select board and finance committee have not yet voted. Ultimately, it's the selectmen's warrant. So if you decide not to approve it tonight, the selectmen, it will stay on there until the selectmen vote on it. If they vote not to recommend it also, they can yank it from the warrant at that point. If they decide to support it, then it would just say recommended by the select board, not recommended by the finance committee.
Because I think there's a lot, I don't know how many, but there, I remember from last year, there was a number of people that, and other special town meetings, that were interested in keeping that old town hall as a real museum-y type thing. And matter of fact, at that point, they weren't even considering voting for the purchase of this building because they wanted that to be the center of the town.
Right.
And so there may be enough people out there that think that this is important. But I'm just saying that it may come to the floor anyway for a vote, and if there are people out there, they may vote it in.
But it's
but at least we won't have the responsibility of saying that we feel that this is...
Joe, I mean, you're going to spend this kind of money, and you know $1.4 million is not going to sell. I mean, no way. No way.
I kind of agree and disagree. Our job is to either
recommend
this article as it is, not whether or not we want the job.
Then I don't recommend it. How's that?
Well, I
I'm saying it's not worded right.
Well, it's not.
I still would recommend it
correctly, but as a finance committee, we also have to make a decision as to whether or not funds are being spent in the right way. You know,
in order to do any work on that building, you have to have architectural degrees.
Correct. Now, which is now, in the past 20 years, this will now be the third time that we've come up to bat and try to get this whole process going.
So what do you recommend? What would you recommend the way around it?
I would think that they have to be transparent and say that, you know, what the end goal is.
That's what I just said. If they put that under 1.4 mil in there, then that is answering your question.
Right.
Okay.
If this was reworded so that it was obvious that there wasn't just
another stab in the dark.
Right.
Well, we've been talking about, we've been beating this thing to death about all these little funds and these little line items and everything of hundreds of dollars. And we're asking for people to make sure they keep track of all this stuff and that we're watching it. And now we're asking for $84,000. Well, you know what? Shame on us, because we've done it just like this before. Just like this. And we saw a project go from 1.7 to 2 point this to 3 point that. You know, there's no end in sight. So if you put a 1.4 number on it, it's going to come back at 1.6. That's the best that we can do. I just think that it's irresponsible to ask people to spend $84,000 and not know what you're getting for it.
Yep.
Other than bid ready documents. I don't know. I know what they are, but does that, you know, okay, great. You know, it doesn't mean anything. There's not the end to it. What to get to spend this $84,000, we're going to ultimately have to spend $1.4 million or $1.5 million or $1.2 million or $400,000, something like that.
So Mary Ellen, and I'm sorry, I don't mean to put you on the spot, Mary Ellen, but I wanted to ask you, because you work with the CPC regularly, are they planning on a presentation for town meeting to support this article? Do you know what's...
I don't know exactly. I can share, if I can, part of the discussion that came up when the application was presented was that the $84,000 for the bid-ready documents, once they're in hand, could be used then to go apply for grants. And there is a laundry list of grants that they are looking to go for to help fund the building, to offset the cost. So that was part of the discussion in terms of why they needed the bid ready documents, because the applications for these grants have to have a bid ready document.
Yeah.
That's for a viable construction project.
So, if, I mean, and I'm not asking you for the answer, but if that's the part of the presentation saying that we need these grants, I'm going to start asking, okay, multiple grants out there adding up to what?
Is it
$20,000 or is it $200,000 or what's the number? Because it's still not going
to make it. They do have a list of those grants that they're looking to apply for.
Right. And then what's the possibility of these things coming through? It's a rhetorical question. I'm not really asking, you know, it's, but those are the things that I think need to be brought out during this.
This is deja vu all over again.
Fool me once, shame on
you. I don't think it's fiscally responsible to ask for something without, you know, okay, here, take this money.
And this happened the last time that town hall came up, and it was put in front of the committee at the last moment. Dan, you were there?
I was there.
You were there? And Wayne? Yeah. We were all there.
It was just pushed right through.
Except for Jim. And we didn't even think it was going to come on, that it was going to be put on town floor. Because we hadn't heard a thing about it throughout the entire year. And then all of a sudden, with 2 weeks left to go, and we never had a soup to nuts presentation on this as to why it should be funded. Well, we're at the same point right now.
Well, I think the public information session that was supposed to be last night was to try to.
Here's another explanation. Here's a hidden, not explanation, but here's another point. We are the finance committee. The only time the finance committee exists is when we're right here. So if one of us goes to one of those meetings, it's not the finance committee, it's a concerned citizen that's gone. If two of us go, it's two concerned citizens. The finance committee has not been approached with a major outlay for the town until town vote. We can't have that again. So here it is again. This has happened again.
There is a lack of communications in the chain.
I'm going to say I don't feel comfortable with this.
I don't either.
Well, the thing is, somebody must be looking at this community preservation fund as their own money. This money. This is tax dollars. We all contribute to this.
Yep.
So I mean, it still should be part of the budget.
Not free cash.
Well, I think CPC sometimes thinks that they have an enterprise.
Yeah. I think we should have a meeting with the selectmen at some point. When's their next meeting?
Monday.
I mean, it would be good to have a discussion with them.
About this particular...
About this?
Where they're going. Where is this going?
Right. Who's watching it? Is there a clerk?
You wouldn't give me any more of an answer than what you would get if you went to that meeting next Wednesday.
You were going to say something? You got a question?
Yes, I'm sort of trying to stop there. I think the difference, I'm not advocating one way or another, but I think the difference from the discussion at the CPC was this is different this time because this building, it would be strictly used as a cultural center, as a community center. So they do feel that there's more viability to get grants for before, because it was a mixed-use building, that's why grants were denied, in which they were applied for, but they were denied. But now, because it's got a specific use, and they do feel there's a better chance of getting it. Again, I'm not advocating one way or another, that's just a point of information that came out in the discussion. So this was discussed. I mean, I sat in on that meeting as a recording secretary, and it was discussed.
Which is great information, and it would be wonderful if we had someone who came to us and said, with this $84,000, we're looking to approach grants in the amount of this, mm-hmm. with the number. Now, if we don't get these grants, this is how we're going to proceed with funding the project. But there's nothing. I mean, there's nothing.
But the 84 isn't covered by anything. That's still going to be coming out of CPA.
Taxpayers. And there's no endpoint. Now, if it's 1.4 million, and that's the line in the sand, and that's where it's going to be, well, let's put that down and let's tell everybody that's where it's going to be. This is not going to be a $3.2 million project.
So do you want to vote on this article separately from the others?
Yes. Yes, we do. Okay. Is there any other article that really... I think just about everything else was
straightforward. Sort of okay.
Okay, so we have a motion.
Make a motion we accept or recommend by the Finance Committee all articles except Article 23.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
One or two things with 23, it can either be left without our recommendation. It doesn't have to state not recommended by the Finance Committee. It just not be put nothing on it, right? As far as I...
That's up to you guys. We have that right. All right.
But,
well, we've been through it before, but I think a lot of them, when we said that we just took our name off of it, weren't really financial. You know, they came up as... You know, I think that this is a financial one, and I think, you know, we took a vote on it, and I think it's not recommended by the Finance Committee.
It states that we looked at it and talked about it.
What do you think about if it was reworded so that it
I think if it was reworded,
covers both CPC qualifications for grants by stating it's for that type of preservation?
Sorry, I didn't get to this part of what you said.
You made the point before that for CPC grants, it has to be, they were looking for the community part of it?
No. When the presentation was made to the CPC committee, they said that in order to get grants outside funding, sources of funding, that they needed bid-ready documents. That was part of the presentation to the CPC.
Oh, just to
approve
the bid-ready.
You know, if it was reworded and we had an explanation as to how monies were going to be gathered and spent downstream after the 40...
We're hedging here to spend $115,000 to work on a building that's being used every day, and we're going to recommend spending $94,000 on something that you have no idea where we're at. And we're hedging as a committee. Should we do it? Should we spend the money to do it here? And it needs to be done here. There, they haven't done anything for 50 years. They can probably go another year. I mean, I don't. I get. Yeah, you want to move forward there, but I just.
I mean, it may pass anyway if we don't have a lot of people showing up and they have. Individuals that want to support it.
Is that still the taxpayer's money? It's not, it still comes from the taxpayer.
I agree. It's our job to either.
You know, we're hedging here, like, okay, should we spend, what's, you know, should we spend $115,000 to keep moving this building forward? And, sure. You know, and this building's used every day, every single day, there's somebody here.
I think if the right numbers, if the total numbers were put in here, then I would vote to recommend. But being that it's written like it is, I agree. I wouldn't recommend it.
Great.
Leave it up to the townspeople. Let evidently what's going to happen is it's not going to get explained. It's going to get explained to us the same time as it's getting explained to the townspeople, and that's going to be on the floor.
Right.
That's what's going to happen.
And if there's a question as to why it's not recommended by the Finance Committee, we'll address that on town floor. And as at this point, there was no presentation made to Finance Committee to justify this expense. I mean, that's just how it is.
Can I ask a question? Just from a CPC standpoint, for applicants who do come in and the applications are approved, going forward, would you prefer these people then, for who get approved applications, come to the Finance Committee? I just would like to be able to pass something along.
I would, and I don't mean to jump right in here, but if somebody's looking to have money spent, that is town money, regardless of what the label is on it, absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
I think that's something that hasn't been required.
This is a pattern that's showing here, and you know it happened the last time, and I'll say it again. You know,
first time
shame on you, second time shame on us if we just said it was good to go.
So any CPC application that is approved, you would like these people then to come to the Finance Committee with the presentation?
Yes.
Okay. I just wanted to get some clarification. So
if it's a major project, and they're asking. I mean, my gosh, the library asked for 15.5, you know, complete explanation of what they were doing, what they needed. She came back with a list of programs that she's going to have. She went out of her way. And yet, we've got a committee in town that wants to spend between 84, 1.4, and 3 million dollars.
Right,
and don't ever come here.
And I'm just trying to note for going forward so I can pass that along to the committee that for any future applicants that they should plan to come to the Finance Committee. So I just wanted clarification going forward. Okay, thank you.
That'd be great.
Okay.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Next meeting?
Can you vote on 23?
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay. I just
What are we voting on?
23.
We made a motion not to.
Basically,
I made a motion to include all of, put a name on all of them except Article 23.
Right.
Okay.
And it was seconded by Lane and voted by everyone.
Okay, sorry, I thought you were going to do them separately. No. I get what you're saying.
No, I'm going to do them all. Yeah.
You have upcoming meetings and calendar on your agenda here for the next item.
What's the date?
5th. Right now, the next.
Well, the first thing, like we talked a little bit before, they want to start early in the first of the year.
Right. Well,
the first thing has to get done is he's going to have to send out the budget to all the departments that want any capital items be submitted by, when is that normally? First part of January.
Capital's first, and then.
And we have to have a capital planning meeting before finance.
Right. Operating. Capital requests are due back by the end of the year. Operating budgets are due back by January 15th. That's how it's been done in the past, anyway.
We also have a meeting coming up with the Water Department in the October, November timeframe. Right?
What department?
The Water Department. The Enterprise Fund.
Oh.
Right?
Yep.
So that may be where we can establish a calendar then. It'd be difficult to do that now. But, I just think, as we discussed, to be able to, look at expenses and see how expenses trend and I think would be helpful before taking a look at the whole budget.
Yeah.
Right? You think so, Jennifer? All right.
If you decide to meet in early fall, that's around the time when free cash, retained earnings are certified. Start the conversation with the water commissioners about using some of their retained earnings to start paying back
mm-hmm.
the town in the FY18 budget. That's also a good opportunity for you guys to decide then when you want to see, do you want to see operation budgets before I submit a draft budget to you? I know I brought that up last time. I mean, you can start looking at the individual budgets as soon as I get them back, if that's something you're interested in doing. Generally, you've been looking at them as a big picture rather than individually, but if you want them sooner, I can, as of the deadline of January 15th, you can see them then. That's
budgets. Yeah. I think the more information we have, the earliest that we can get it is better.
The more information you have spread out over a longer period of time, the better than getting it all at once.
Yeah.
The more you absorb.
And these other reports coming to us would be very helpful as well.
You'll get those monthly, all year, even during the summer. So
I'll tell you what I would like, what would be helpful, at least for me, is that when we meet, when the calendar is structured, that we can vote on anything we need to vote on reflected against the tax rate. So, fire truck, 145K, or whatever, dump truck, 145K, we can look at that. We can say, this is what it's going to do to the tax rate, yay or nay.
Are you talking about next year? Are you talking about town meeting this year?
No, I'm talking about.
Just for the sake of argument.
Yeah. Because what happens now is, it's like we vote on everything, and next week you put everything together, and it comes here. Here we are. That's not quite the way it should go. It should go like they're coming to us, they present, we look at the numbers, does it make sense? Then we say, you're going to have to tell them that it's going to adversely affect the tax rate and that we're not going to support that. Or just the opposite. Yeah, that's great. Let's go ahead.
You love to use a lot of assumptions there. Assuming that you're going to have X number of dollars in reserve funds or cash, free cash, and stuff like that.
The thing is, we get a number now. We've got a number. We know we're down a half buck in tax rate. So we know that. Okay. Why do we have to vote on it right now? We have to vote on it right now because town meeting's coming up. So we got to get to the town meeting. Does that mean we push the town meeting further out so that
our bylaws require the last Tuesday, right?
Yeah.
I mean, we can't without changing our bylaws.
Well, and somehow we have to work on this calendar where we don't have 1 week
to make all the decisions
and no rebuttal. There's pretty much no rebuttal. They come in, it's as good as I'm okay, all right, well, it's done. We got to have a process where we can push back, and we can push back not because it doesn't feel right, or we push back because there's a legitimate reason, and it has to do with the impact to the tax rate.
I think me forwarding you departmental budgets to look at individually early is probably the best idea. I mean, once I present a budget, things do happen really fast, and it's just kind of the nature of keeping on track and getting it, you know. There isn't a lot of time for me in between, which, you know, I mean, you know, you guys make the decisions and I go back and make the adjustments or come back to you with new inserts. Mm-hmm. I mean, I spend an incredible amount of time from in between meetings doing
that. I'm sure you do.
And there isn't a lot of extra time in there, I guess. That's why I tend to press you for decisions because one decision can change,
right?
Can trickle down.
And it just,
I think having more information earlier is better. I agree with you on
having
that.
More information earlier has to help in that process.
We might not be able to make decisions earlier because we're going to have more time to discuss. But having that information and saying, okay, this looks good, we met with the department head, and that looks good, we can set it aside for now, we'll vote on it later. But, or we could vote on it, but something happens, you know, with the COLA and the longevity and all these things, there are changes that are made in those budgets.
Yeah.
But having it early, we get set aside the stuff that doesn't take that much time, and then we'll have the time to devote on the more difficult budgets as it comes closer to the time of the annual meeting.
Yeah. We just have to have a system where where we are justified in saying yes or no beyond what seems practical. So there has to be a number.
But you're not really referencing the regular budgets. You're referencing capital items or major expenses or building committee.
But even the budget.
But even the budget itself.
What you asked for before was the straight budget. You know what's going on with their budget to see what they got left. And that's hard to do because, as I just pointed out to him, you've got the thing about the school there, the
tennis courts.
Well, the softball field or whatever, not being, and it says $0 spent, right? Because you got to go through this transfer of the funds before you get that knocked down, right? So just looking at that report isn't going to give you a true picture of what they are driving for, or what has is going to give you a true picture of what dollar has been expended.
One of the things would have been the workman's comp issue. The workman's comp issue, when it got, I need this much money now. We would have known a while ago where it was headed.
What?
The workman's comp. You need more money for workman's comp.
Unemployment.
Oh, okay. And we would have known way out in front instead of saying, well, we need this much money here. Like,
but there's no way for us to
know. I know that.
Well, we can over budget for it every year. I mean,
I think you could have, almost could have predicted that one. I only think of that one situation.
But she, not really, because I think you're referring to our treasurer collector.
Mm-hmm.
The cop. That was what drove the.
Right.
Okay. So she left the town in August, which was 2 months after the start of the fiscal year and 4 to 5 months before town meeting or after town meeting, and probably 6 to 8 months before you guys were doing the budget. I mean, there's no way you can see 8 months down the road and predict that this particular employee isn't going to last. And I mean, maybe you can with some people, I don't know, but that's not.
Just look at the example of that $84,000. I mean, right now, we push back on it because there wasn't enough information, okay? Now, what if there was enough information? $1.4 million is what it's gonna be at the end, add on the 84, this is what the whole project is gonna be. Would we be able to, you know, are we sophisticated enough to be able to look forward and say what kind of impact that's going to have on the tax rate?
I think you need to be able to look forward at your wants and needs.
Yeah. Well, what we do. I mean, we do. We have a capital planning committee, and we've got, you know, trucks and buildings and repairs all kind of doled out to the future, so we have a lot of that.
I think what you're driving at more towards the regular budgets. And there's so many things that you can't foresee, like Keith had his budget pretty good on winter roads all until 2 days ago. And then Mother Nature threw a curveball.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Well, anyway, we'll start with more information, and if there's the desire to reword and further explain, you know, the town hall project, then there may be.
I have a feeling you'll give a lengthy presentation at town meeting.
Yeah.
From the parties that.
But they're not going to address it before town meeting?
With the finance committee?
Yeah, no. The finance committee is not going to address that question before town meeting?
No, we don't really have another meeting.
We don't. We're just not going to put our signature on it as recommended by it.
Right.
Look, actually, let me clarify. Are you not recommending it, or are you just not including a recommendation?
We cannot recommend to the people of the town that they vote for it. That's what we do on every...
So you want to say we do not recommend?
I would prefer to say that we do not recommend it.
But that's what I wanted to know, whether you just want it removed or whether you want to use it.
Yeah, I agree. I agree, because I know I still... It's 94,000, like...
And we consider it.
I still go back to this question. Are you going to change the wording of this?
Apparently, you let us know.
No, we're going to not recommend it.
If the...
We're not going to recommend it.
If the article is not going to be reworded to include total amounts and stuff, then I would say, yes, that's the way we word it, because there's not enough information there.
I don't think they know any total amounts, even though you said they're going to build the 1.4.
I'm still waiting for the chair of the CPC to weigh in on these articles. I had to have something drafted to present to you guys tonight, but the wording may change, and there's nothing I can do. I haven't heard back whether or not...
Who's the chair of the CPC?
All I'm saying is that everything, if the wording changes significantly on this before...
Or after the change of...
You can do a straw vote to the members of the finance committee via email.
Yeah, you could.
I don't think we're changing the wording.
He just said they haven't had the final say on it yet. NBC isn't even done with it. Unless you know more than the rest of us.
Why don't I do this? When I get any revisions back from the CPC, I'll forward the revisions along to you guys. If you feel like you want to reconvene, let me know. We'll get a meeting posted.
This would probably happen along with the selectmen after they look at it.
No, once the selectmen look at it, it's signed.
Huh?
Once the selectmen look at it on Monday, it gets signed and it's posted. There's no changing it at that point. So it would have to be between tonight and Monday.
Okay.
I also need 48 hours of operating time to get legally posted. So we're talking about Thursday or Monday.
Yeah. We're good.
Okay. Make a motion, Jerry.
Second. All those in favor?